Welcome to this video. My name is Hassan Rahal, and today I will introduce you to System Composer, one of MathWorks' system engineering tools that is used for the design and analysis of software architectures. Typically, in any activity or any project that we start the early concept of the description phase. Here, we capture the overall system requirements and more information on the details and thoughts of the concept. As a system engineer, you usually begin working on whiteboards and then move on to more formal and informal requirements, specifications, and architectures. During this process, you will allocate requirements to architectural components and perform trade studies to optimize these architectures for different design concerns. This can sometimes create a problem, since the tools used to tackle these challenges often do not connect well to the other tools used throughout the design process, like in the modeling and simulation. MathWorks system engineering tools combine with MATLAB and Simulink to create a unified modeling environment, enabling the use of a single platform throughout system engineering design, implementation, and verification processes. With System Composer, you can allocate requirements while refining an architecture model that can then be designed and simulated in Simulink. In short, System Composer allows you to bridge the gap between the early conceptual phases and the later model development phase. It also helps in creating that digital thread, thus ensuring a connected development environment. We will see this more details during this demo. As a summary, System Composer allows you to create and elaborate specifications of architectures, compositions, and interfaces for model-based system engineering and software. You can also use it for requirements allocation and traceability, creating profiles and analysis models, creating spotlights and model views, and performing behavior modeling. So let's see that in action. We will start by creating a blank architecture model from the Simulink start page. This will be our main canvas, which we will name Robot Architecture. On this canvas, we will create three subcomponents representing the different subcomponents of our robot: sensing, thinking, and acting. As you see, System Composer allows us to define our system components with a high level of abstraction at an early stage of the development before diving into the modeling phase. Using System Composer, you can create multiple layers of subsystems. By double-clicking on the sensing component, we can create more subsystems. In this case, we will define a LiDAR subcomponent, a camera subcomponent, and a subcomponent for the sensor fusion. To connect our subcomponents to one another, it is enough to click on the border of one and drag our mouse to the other. This connection represents the flow of information between the subsystems, which will later be defined in more details. We can double-click on the connector and name it with a more defined representation. By connecting the output of one subcomponent to the parent, we will be able to define the output information of this subcomponent. In this case, it will be the fused data. As you can see, we can then create a link to the parent components, which will reflect the same naming. Let us now investigate more features of System Composer. The first one is variant choice. Let us assume we are testing two path planning algorithms and we are not sure which one will fit us better. We can do that by creating a variant component within the System Composer menu. We will call this component Path Planning, and inside it, we will have two design options, one of them representing an A star algorithm and the other representing a D star algorithm. Going back to our main menu, we can connect the fused data input to this subcomponent. Using variants, we can quickly swap different architectural designs for a component while performing analysis. We can do that by right-clicking, going to variant, and then choosing the proper variant choice. You can see that this is automatically highlighted in System Composer, showing you the active variant at the moment. The output of the path planning will be fed into a path following component. Here we will see how we can link an architecture component to an actual Simulink model. This can simply be done by creating a component, calling it path follow, and then right-clicking and linking it to a model. Here we can browse to our model and then clicking OK. You can see that automatically our model will take the inputs and outputs of the Simulink model. Moreover, if we go inside the model, we can see our actual pre-saved Simulink model. We can now connect the output of the path planning subcomponent to our path following subcomponent. We can also link the outputs of the path following to the parent subcomponent. We can now finalize our architectural design by linking the speed and angle to the acting subcomponent. Often in the architectural design, we need to capture non-functional properties to verify structural and functional requirements. This can be done using stereotypes. A stereotype is a custom expansion of the modeling language. Stereotypes provide a mechanism to extend the architecture language elements by adding domain-specific metadata. To do that, we can simply click on Profile Editor. We can create our custom profile, which in this case we will call a robot. And then we can start to add stereotypes under our profile. In this case, we will create two stereotypes, a hardware stereotype and a software stereotype. Within the stereotype, we can add different properties representing physical or functional components of this stereotype. In the case of the hardware stereotype, we will add a mass and an IP rating stereotypes. Both of these are double elements, and the unit for the mass is kg. We can also add a custom icon after applying this stereotype to our components to make it easier to recognize this stereotype on the main canvas. We will do the same with our software stereotype, assigning a memory allocation property. Once you save these, we can save this profile, and then we can use it for this project and more. To do that, we can simply import our stereotype and now we can start by assigning stereotypes to our components. For example, the acting will fall directly under the hardware stereotype. You can see by choosing the hardware stereotype, it will be automatically reflected with the icon. We can do the same with our sensing subcomponent, assigning the LiDAR and camera to the hardware stereotype while assigning the sensor fusion to the software one. Keep in mind that some components can carry multiple stereotypes. For example, the sensing parent subcomponent is at the same time a hardware and a software stereotype. If we want to change any property for one of the stereotypes, we can click on the property inspector. And here we can add the mass of this component and the IP rating. These properties can then be called using a MATLAB script or using the analysis model in order to, for example, estimate the total mass or the total memory needs of our system. Now we will investigate some visualization tools of System Composer. We will start with spotlight views. By clicking on a specific subcomponent, we can click on architecture views and create a spotlight. The spotlight will show you this component as well as the upstream and downstream connections of this component. In the case of the thinking, we can see that it is connected to the sensor fusion as an upstream and to the acting as a downstream. Now let us investigate architecture views. With an architecture view, you can view a system based on different hierarchies. To create an architectural view, you can click on Architecture Views app. Here we can create a new view. And for this view, we can use the filtering and configuration settings below in order to specify what can be seen with this view. In this case, we are trying to see the components that are carrying a hardware stereotype. By applying our query, we can see a more filtered view of our system. Let us change this to software, apply our query, and we can see the software components. Views create a simplified way to work with complex architectures by focusing on certain parts of the architectural design. As a final step, we will see how we can link requirements to our architecture model using Simulink requirements. We will not dive deeply into how Simulink requirements work since we will have another video for that. But we will just show how we can link an existing requirement set to our architecture. We can do that by going to the apps section of our Simulink and choosing requirements manager. It will first ask us to save our architecture. And then it will be able to open the Requirements Manager tab. Here we are going to import a predefined set of requirements, which we have saved in a Word file. By clicking Import, it will allow us to add all our predefined requirements to our model. If you look here, you can see all the predefined requirements that we had in the Word document. To assign requirements, we can simply drag a specific requirement to a specific subcomponent in our System Composer canvas. You can see it will automatically create the requirements link. We can do the same to the other subcomponents in our system. Multiple requirements can be linked to one block, and multiple blocks can be linked to the same requirements. To see which requirements are linked to what components, you can click on the requirement under question, and then it will automatically highlight all the linked subcomponents. This connection creates a digital thread to navigate between system requirements, architecture models, implementation models, and embedded software, which is one of the main advantages of model-based design. We hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, please feel free to reach out to us and we will be happy to help you with any questions that you have. You can learn more about System Composer on the following links. Thank you and have a very nice day.